Hey, what's up guys, this is Daddy Cool and you are watching Black and White Good God playthrough. Now this is the 11th episode of this playthrough and we are in the fourth island at the moment. The good thing is that I have eliminated all the bad things on this island. I mean, you can see that there is no fire rain, no storm, and the sky is blue instead of red. And yeah, in previous episode I have conquered this village, but we have one more remaining thing here to do, and it's to conquer this skeleton village, which is not that easy, not that hard, but still we will do it somehow. The thing is that we have to increase these two pillars up to the maximum, and for this I need the help of the creature, which I will be trying to do. And in the meantime I am planning my travel to the next island, the last and main goal of this playthrough, the fifth island. And for that one I will create a couple of scaffolds, I mean 7 sized scaffolds into this position, and also try to prepare as much as I can, because it's not an easy quest and challenges there. Okay, so let's get going. So first things first, I'm gonna create miracle food and
Norse power
miracles into this village. Also I'm gonna put some villagers into this village, and in the meantime
miracle wood.
I think I will have to put a couple of houses as well into the village so they can expand. And this is size 3. Let's put a civic building as well. Doesn't take too much time to create that one. Did not succeed. Come on, is there? Oh, I'm killing a pig. Okay, now it's okay. And let's create wood.
Miracle wood.
Norse power.
And once more.
Miracle wood.
Norse power.
The good thing is that my creature is pretty stable. As a good creature, and I do not have to watch him closely anymore. I mean, yeah, he can make some stupid things all the time, but it's less frequent than in the beginning. Okay, let's put one more person here. Okay, he's eating, that's good. One more person into here.
Miracle food.
Norse power.
The people. I don't know, the storehouse is
miracle food.
Almost full, and they are still requiring the food.
Miracle food.
Norse
for some
power
reasons. Okay. Let's take the frames and house in here. That's good.
Miracle heal.
I'm gonna heal the people as well.
Miracle heal.
Okay.
Miracle heal.
Just like in there.
Miracle Miracle food.
Norse power.
And the food. Okay, I'm gonna take the scaffold, put it here. I think it's, yeah, well, use 7 scaffolds. There is one more scaffold piece missing from the third
Miracle
one.
Miracle wood.
Norse power.
And actually they are much easier to transport if size is 7. Okay, influence is increasing, that's good.
Must build home.
That thing is also done. We are building the homes. Yeah, they can move into the houses if they wish to. And let's take this person into the village.
Must build home.
And maybe one more. There you go. And let's create the wood spell.
Miracle wood.
Norse power.
So that the influence is growing a little bit.
Miracle heal.
Maybe a heal. Okay.
Miracle food.
Norse power.
Some food as well. This doesn't give me believers, but they require a lot of food, as they say. Let's take some food from that storehouse into this one. Yeah, that's gonna be fine. Okay, now this village is not really working.
Miracle wood.
Norse
just
power.
Yet, I'm gonna give them some wood. Let's create a disciple builder.
Disciple builder.
Hopefully it will be ready soon. Influence is growing, getting closer, that's fine. These ones also being collected and prepared into this position.
Miracle wood.
Norse power.
There you go.
Miracle wood.
Norse power.
This one is for. No, it's the proper size. So I have 3. I'm planning to have roughly, I don't know, 8 pieces maybe. From
Miracle
thing.
Wood.
Oh, the creature. Do you want to sleep? Because in that case, I'm not gonna disturb him. I'm gonna let him rest for sure. Okay, this is ready.
Must build homes.
Let's create a disciple breeder, I think. No, there are a couple of children. I do not need more, I suppose. Let's create food for them.
Miracle food.
Norse power.
And I wanna create a farmer.
Disciple farmer.
And another one.
Disciple farmer.
Okay. It's fine. Creature is not in there. I'm gonna pet him just for now because otherwise he feels bad.
Miracle wood.
Norse power.
There you go.
Miracle wood.
Norse power.
Okay. 4 already.
Miracle food.
Norse power.
We have more believers. Yeah, this influence area is already pretty big. Let's take the creature into the other.
Disciple breeder.
City maybe. But first, come get some food because you are a little bit hungry. Okay, let's come into this village and do some nice stuff here.
Miracle heal.
Oh, that heal was very useful.
Miracle food.
Norse power.
Ooh, did not build homes. Not very much needed.
Miracle wood.
Norse power.
And some wood as well for them.
Must build homes.
Oops, I misdropped a little bit of wood.
Miracle food.
Norse power.
Miracle heal.
Oops, I
miracle heal.
Misclicked that one. Let's heal people in here. Okay, that worked.
Miracle wood
again.
Norse power.
The creature is there. It's fine.
I must build homes.
I'm gonna attach you maybe here. And yeah, you can do anything you wish in that village. They say we need more homes, but as you can see, the homes are half empty. So I don't really know why they require more homes. Still, I'm gonna put some people into
live here in peace.
This village. There you go. And influence is, yeah, growing steadily. That's wonderful, I can say.
We must build homes.
Okay, the creature is also nice to them.
Miracle wood.
Norse power.
Sanctuary.
Not sanctuary. I wanted to have food.
Miracle food.
Norse power.
And also into the storehouse.
Miracle food.
Norse power.
Size 7. Okay. 3 more scaffold smithing.
Miracle heal.
From my plans that we will see if that's gonna be enough.
Miracle wood.
Norse power.
Okay, what's the sanding in here? Oh, he threw a pig into the storehouse, right? The fish. Okay, that's also nice. He learned how to use the storehouse. And kind to people. well-thought creature, I think.
Miracle Wood.
Norse power.
Miracle Wood.
Norse power.
Yeah, that's the size, I think. It's ready. Yeah, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7.
Disciple Breeder.
Okay. What about the creature? Wow. Children desire expansion, right?
Offspring.
And offspring. You have enough children. No? Let's create a heal.
Miracle heal.
Old person there, who is cured now. And let's create
Disciple Breeder.
Okay, let's put maybe three more people there.
Live here in love.
Yeah. What's this? Okay, one more person.
Offspring.
Great. That was a good drop. Wants to mess around with you. What you doing? Okay. Yep. Okay, I'm gonna unleash him. You can do and go what you wish to do and wherever you wish to go. Hopefully come back to the church, I mean not church, this main building, and have some rest. And in the meantime, yeah, a couple of scaffolds are ready. Okay.
Miracle Wood.
Norse.
And I think I am missing offsprings, so I'm gonna decrease the tower level and create some cycle breeders. Oops.
Disciple breeder. Disciple breeder. Disciple breeder.
Like this. Scaffolds. Fine.
Miracle Wood.
Norse power.
Miracle Wood.
Norse power.
So where is the creature? Not here for sure. Really see him anywhere, not in my village either. Size 6. No. Size 7. Okay.
Miracle Wood.
Norse power.
I didn't really see my creature. Oh, there he is. Probably he is coming back to this village to eat, to sleep, or whatever he wished to do.
Miracle food.
Norse power.
Teleport.
Let's put a teleport there. Yeah, he came back home to sleep. Good boy.
Miracle wood.
I'm not gonna disturb him. He needs the rest.
Norse power.
Okay. Influence level. Oh, perfect. Now I can reach that thing there. So you're hungry? Take the food. Take the food. Okay. Let's create a rock here. And he needs to poop. Bad boy. Bad boy, we are not pooping the houses. Yeah, that's okay. Oh, it's night time. Go there. Night time is the growing time for the creature, so it's pretty good if he sleeps there during the night. Okay, and not disturbing him while he sleeps. That's the plan. Okay, and when he wakes up, I'm gonna pick the truck. And we will try to move the pillars and solve the last quest on this island. But I let him sleep to gain strength, grain size, and yeah, be a bigger creature. Create a spell like this.
Miracle wood.
Norse power.
Also food.
Miracle food.
Norse power.
That's nice. Influence is oh wonderful. Oh, that's good. The creature is sleeping a lot. Maybe the whole night. I'm gonna reward him for this. That's good. Okay. He has already learned this thing, at least. I'm gonna fill this building in the meantime while he is sleeping. Yeah. So let's pick this up. That's the plan. Can you pick it up? I mean, okay, now okay, he has picked up the stone, and I'm gonna run with him with the stone in hand. And normally this should increase his strength. I mean, this should increase his strength better than just picking up and putting the stone down. So running with stone in hand is the real solution to gain strength. Okay, I do not want him to eat the stone. It's a stupid thing that you should be avoiding with the creature normally. Come this way. This way. Do you still have the stone? Yeah. That's fine. Okay, we will be there in no time. That's nice. Come on, walk, walk, walk. Okay, and let's put the stone in there. Okay, let's try to send him there. No, I cannot. Then I'm gonna leash him here. And let's check the learning leash. Like this. And I'm gonna raise the statue. Yeah, let's do it once more. That's it. And hopefully he will raise the statue, and I will do it also with the other one. And that should be... that should be done. I mean, it's not working. I'm not sure if we have to raise it together with the same speed or oh yeah, we have to reach the maximum at the same time.
We owe you everything. We can tell you where the creed you need can be found. The creed lies in the body of the one you knew as the guide.
Okay. I think the creature should be both here, maybe. Yeah, that seems to be the solution. I mean, within it's within influence area. Okay, let's take the creature there. Come on. And he should be coming to this position. Yeah. Okay, in the meantime, I'm gonna continue the work.
Miracle Wood.
Norse power.
Create spells.
Miracle Wood.
Norse power.
Fill the storehouse all the time.
Miracle Wood.
Norse power.
Where is the creature? Oh, here he is. He's coming to this point.
You found the second creed!
Yeah! Oh, this is a great day!
What was that?
That's a good question. What was that? Nothing is really happening, but preparation cannot wait.
That was big! It came from over there.
Actually, that was big.
Miracle Wood.
Norse power.
Miracle Wood.
Norse power.
Not staying down with the spells. Also some food sometimes.
Miracle Food.
Norse power.
What's the situation here? Almost ready.
Miracle Wood.
Norse power.
There you go. Wood. Spells, aggressive creature. No, I do not want to have an aggressive creature.
Miracle Wood.
Norse power.
Okay. Come eat something, please.
Miracle Wood.
Norse.
So 6 pieces of 7 value, 6 value, 5 value. Okay. I'm gonna create
a teleport.
Teleport into here. What's the situation? It just needs a little bit of building. Oh, we have a builder. Let's create a woodcutter.
Disciple Forester.
Uh-oh! I got another rumble then, boss.
20,000 wood, 12,000 food. That's nice.
Miracle food.
What about here? 17 food, 20 wood. Okay, store houses are
miracle wood.
Pretty fast. Okay, this one into here. And this one into here.
Miracle wood.
I'm really not sure what this rumbling sound is.
Miracle food.
Norse power.
Teleport.
The village store is nearly out of food.
Which one? Oh, this one. It's ready.
Miracle food.
Norse power.
We're low on wood.
Yeah, I'm pretty good.
Miracle wood.
Norse power.
Uh-oh. I got another rumble then, boss.
Wow, this just gave a lot of levers. Okay. Move along.
Miracle wood.
Norse power.
There you go. And one more.
Miracle food.
Norse power.
That was also nice. And I think I'm gonna put some food from this storehouse into that one. Just to give, I mean, just to receive some believers. Seven, eight, nine. Let's put 10,000. Yeah, nice. And I think I can also put some wood as well. Come on, the shaking cancel the combining.
Miracle wood.
Norse power.
These rumblings seem to be getting faster, leader.
Let's put some wood into here. 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm gonna put maybe 15,000 pieces. Yeah, like this. Now it's filled. What about here?
Homes.
We are fine in here as well.
Miracle food.
Norse power.
Miracle wood.
Norse power.
These rumblings seem to be getting faster, leader.
Okay, and what can I do about it? I don't really get it.
Miracle wood.
Yeah, they are more frequent, I think.
The Rumbling's really fast now, boss.
Miracle Wood.
Norse power.
Yes, my adversary. You have the second part of the creed, but it is useless unless you have three parts. But I am still more powerful than you can possibly imagine. I have opened a vortex to my realm. Come through, I invite you, for only you and I remain. Come and face your destiny.
Yeah, time to take on Nemesis. Oh, I've been waiting for this.
If we go through, there's no coming back. This is where we stand or fall.
Hey, you're right. Boss, are we ready for this? I mean, we might die through there.
We might. If we go through, we must be well prepared for what we face. And we should send plenty of food, wood, and followers into the vortex as well.
Okay, so I think we have arrived to the point where I should be preparing well for this advancing to the next level, and I think the couple of next moves will be a little bit boring till I gather all the believers I would like to into the next level, all the frames, plenty of food and wood just as it was requested. So I think I'm gonna cut the recording now, and we'll be back when I have put into the vortex everything. So see you in a couple of seconds. Okay, so I have already done everything I wanted. As you can see, the village is pretty empty. I have put everyone into the vortex. And not just that village, I have emptied this village as well, and this village as well. There are absolutely no people on that village. Regarding resources, I have thrown a couple of scaffolds into the vortex, and food and wood as well, so we are pretty full on the other side. And I would like to check the creature just for a moment. He looks very cute. He is glowing in blue, and he has a horn. So we have created the desired unicorn, which I'm really happy about. And let's check his things, because in the next map these will change and I cannot turn it back anymore. So he's 14 years old. His alignment is angelic, which is the best, I mean the most good alignment. He has some energy, I mean full of energy, and he has a moderate strength. And yeah, that were the things I wanted to show you. And as I have everything prepared, it's time to visit Land 5.
Face the ultimate foe, boss. But hey, let's show no fear.
I have been watching your power grow. You are the only foe left, and I have enjoyed your success. The stronger you are, the more impressive it will be when I crush you. Once I destroy you, every living creature in Eden will worship me, Nemesis. The embodiment of evil. I gain nothing from defeating the weak. Only now are you worth beating. And all your power, all your worshippers will be mine. That, my enemy, is the ultimate prize. I have a surprise for you. You'll find your creature is different since I cursed him.
Phew! Our creature seems to be all right. We'd better keep a close eye on him, though.
Okay, so we have arrived to the fifth island. And before we do anything serious, I would like to check where we are at the moment. So this is the area we are starting in. There are a couple of villages here, like this one. It has a pretty big influence, and this one, which is roughly the same. And there is one village here. This is our first target, the priority target, which I want to conquer as soon as possible, because then I will have access to the other two directions. Here is another village which is neutral at the moment, so Nemesis does not have influence on that village. And this is Nemesis's third village, and that would be good to conquer also, but probably this will be the last village I can conquer. And this is his creature, a pure evil and pretty big creature. And this is his temple, which we have to reach. In general, this is the last goal of this map. And yeah, we will see what's the problem with the creature, but just as I said, yeah, he's still pretty cute. I really like the design, and yeah, I'm really happy about the creature that I could create such a nice partner for this quest. And as you can see, I have gathered a lot of resources into this map, including the artifacts that I have. There are, if I'm counting well, 7 artifacts in my possession, a lot of scaffolds, some spells, and plenty of villagers, which maybe I have made bad, because this means it will be very hard to fulfill their requirements for living space and such, but we will see how I will manage this. Okay, let's get going. So I wait my creature to be good, I mean known eats, and...
I sense something special about this place. Don't forget it. We should come back this way later.
And first things first, creature going to that village. I'm gonna slow down the time a bit because I want to make some order here, and for that I do not want to waste the precious time that I have on this village, I mean on this map, and on the slow time method I have enough time to move the map and place every object and every detail into the desired position. Okay, I'm gonna collect the scaffolds maybe into here, close to the temple, because then they are not producing anything from themselves. Okay, and I'm gonna collect the spells into... No, maybe there. They are not disturbing anyone. Okay. And if I'm ready with the organization of things, I'm gonna create a couple of buildings for this settlement. And also will keep a close eye on my creature that he is doing good things and that he is conquering that village, because that's very important, just as I said. Okay, he's going. I will reward him if he is trying to impress the villagers for sure, because that's the job he has to do. Okay, let's put this here and take... Okay, the temple has been built, that's good. Let's check. He wants to impress somebody. Let's give some food. And you want to impress? I reward him. Slow down time again, gather the scaffolds, this one as well. Oop. Not really how I planned, but also okay. And I wanna create a lot of houses, so I need to break these scaffolds into smaller pieces. Okay. Slow down time once more. We need...
We're running out of wood.
To size the scaffolds for the houses. There are two type of houses that you can build, a smaller one and a bigger one, and both of them are generated from the same two scaffolds, but the bigger one can has space for 5 people and the smaller one for 4 people, so obviously I try to build the bigger house. That's the smaller one.
Your people have a desire. Bigger. Tough for them, but life goes on.
Oh yeah, and I have not mentioned that there is another village in here, and maybe the shipwreck on the left hand side seems familiar for you. That's the ship we have helped in the first episode, in the maybe the first or the second episode, I'm not sure, but yeah, that's the ship who were singing and requesting things from me. Okay, fulfilling some needs here. I'm gonna give them some food and probably they will be okay for a little bit longer time. Maybe I will give them one more house as well to satisfy their needs. There we go, food and wood. That should be normally enough for you. Yeah.
Disciple breeder.
Wood doesn't give any more benefit now. So let's get back into this village and try to build some good things here, like this graveyard. No, I want a graveyard. Yep. Okay, and the rest of the scaffolds gonna be turned into houses. Okay. Well, maybe if you are also planning to make playthrough with the game, I suggest for this level do not take so many people, because you are just building them, they have desires, and it's very hard to fulfill on this map, as wood is a little bit hard to come by. There are some starting forests, but other than that, the temples do not have spell for wood, and once the forest has been cut down, you do not really have proper source of wood for building. So yeah, this is one thing I have made bad, but I have overwritten the save file, and my last normal save is the one which you have just seen after preparing for the vortex tip. So yeah, I have made a mistake, but I'm not gonna go back a couple of hours just for this mistake. So we live with this huge village, and I try to manage this. Oh, that's a free sized. Yeah, I need just two. So I'm gonna build three more houses, I think, just for now, and after that I will leave these people a little bit to build these buildings. Guide my creature to conquer that village. Yeah, he's okay. He's dancing. We need 560. It started at 900, so he's doing good. This one is almost 900 believers needed, and this one is probably more. Yeah, 1000. Because the enemy god in this map is generating believers for himself, so we are competing, and I have to be a better god, more believer generator god, to be able to finish this map. Okay. What else can I do? have the storehouse. Yeah, 2000 wood. As you can see, I have a lot of piles of wood, but unfortunately, although I have put 20,000 pieces of stacks, but only 2 or 3,000 pieces, or even 750 pieces, have arrived. Yeah, like this one. So that's it. We have to live with this. Okay. Speed up the time a little bit. Oh, that's good. Come on, I want to reward you. There you go, you're a good boy. And let's check this scroll. Just really fast.
You are the true god. This is the time of salvation. Your flame burns bright, but there are still shadows. Let me help you to light up the whole world. I'd like to tell you more of what I know. Your creature is infected by a spiritual curse. Its power is greatest when the sun has set. This wonder is giving the curse its power. While it stands, it will drain your creature's strength. You must destroy it to restore strength to your creature. I'd like to tell you more of what I know. But first, I must rest and pray. Please return tomorrow.
What's going on with him? Phew! Our creature seems to be all right.
Okay, so now we know what's the problem with the creature. And I'm gonna stop the time just here and now, because 1 hour have passed since the start of this episode, and I do not want to really overdo things just now. So thank you for watching, guys, and see you in the next episode. Goodbye.